efforts on Boko Haram insurgents, on outsourcing in small and medium enterprises in Adamawa and Borno states, Nigeria, presented by D. Mohammed. Then introduction. From the introduction, I think I can use my voice. These pictures you see here, this is Mohammed Yusuf. This is Mohammed Yusuf, the real originator of Boko Haram. This is Sheikha. This is Sheikha. And this is Abu Musa Azarbao. This Sheikha, after the arrest and kill of Mohammed Yusuf, then this one react. As they react, they form what we call Islamic militants. Formerly, the government underestimated it to be just like a mere militant extremist group, just mere extremist group. But with time, you know what happened. This is Sheikha. This picture, I don't know if you can differentiate it, but from the source, military intelligence, that these two people, they are two different people. When this one was killed, then this one took over. But you hardly differentiate. I don't know if you can see, but the differentiation, maybe the way they talk, the mouth, the eyes, and there are some other informations which is not here. This one took over from this, and this one took over from this, and now this one, who is dressed here, took over from this one. So, this black flag rings a bell. Wherever you see this black flag, a Nigerian, or I don't know, a Syrian, will know what this flag means. And personnel, they also know what this flag means. As you see this flag, even now that I'm seeing it, my mind is shaking, because I know the atrocities of this flag. The flag always rings a bell. As soon as you see this flag, you know something is wrong. Something is about to happen. Who are making it to happen? This, this, and these people, you see. Always well armed, either armed in the sense with sophisticated weapons or armed with an improvised weapon. Always armed. So they are not to be underestimated. These people, the three introduced, continue to terrorize the government and people of Nigeria, most importantly in the northeastern state, running down lives and properties. They don't care. You can see, these are some of the pictures where they conduct their attacks. This Boko Haram continue to terrorize the government and citizenry of Nigeria in a threat to national security. Day after day, pressing messages to violence, killings and destruction of valuable properties for their selfish interests that brought them into life, that is education. All of them, all of these people that you see, they are well-educated people. They are educated in not only the Western education, they have their Islamic education. What happened? This is their ideology.
Hello and welcome to TBC News Investigates. Ali, we know, like a thief in the night, the Boko Haram infect. He did Nigeria's northeast in 2013 and 2014, both Gwoza and Uba Nokute. Urban areas of Borno State were witnesses to Boko Haram's fire. The terror group also seized that opportunity to voice its flag there. As a result of the countless attacks, the people of northeastern Nigeria have never known peace, despite every effort by the Nigerian military to cross the insurgency. And this package titled Boko Haram Killers Among Us, TVC News investigates Adan Ibui brings us first hand accounts by survivors of the insurgents' attacks.
So he must have learned it. And why did he learn it? It's in the school. So he learned this in the school. That means he went through Western education, that is the secular education. But now they are going against it. They say they are against secular education, sports, and music, because this is the source of all evil. Oh, problem statement. As announcement made by this insurgent about the secular education, sports, and music, then the difficult livelihood start in that area. Business activities has been crumbled, production processes has been disturbed, businesses, enterprises has collapsed, and all other issues, all anomalies began. So people, property, and everything is being destroyed, and it is in problem. So as such, the main objective of this study is to examine the effect of Boko Haram insurgents on outsourcing of the small and medium enterprises in Borno and Adamawa State, northeast Nigeria, with specific objective to ascertain aftermath of the insurgents' activities on the SMEs and to offer solution or way forward, if any, about that issue. So the literature here is that Boko Haram, that is popularly known, this is not their official name. Their official name is the Jamaatul Ahl Sunnah the Dawati wa Jihad, and they were founded in 2002. Then in 2014, the FBI declared them as terrorists. 2015, in the Global Terrorist Index, become the most deadly terror in the world. Let me just quickly, since the bell has been rung. Why they were caught? They don't care. You can see. They don't care. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to them. Look at animal. This is a young kid. Look at nursing mother. People, they don't care. They do their attack anytime, any good day, anywhere. arms fully loaded, buildings destroyed, human over 250 at once, over 250. Why still? Look at the statistic from the Institute of Economic and Peace that brought up why Boko Haram is more deadly and dangerous than even ISIS. 77% of their deaths were private citizens. In only 453 attacks, they killed about 6,644 civilians. Whereas ISIS, in 1,071 attack, they killed only 6,000, of which Boko Haram is not even half of this attack, but killing 6,644. Assuming if they now double this figure, how it will look like with the ISIS. So this is one part of the problem that shows that Boko Haram is more deadlier. Because of lack of time, there is a video here that shows one of their dangerous nature. They bring out some sophisticated, some improvised devices, which you cannot even detect. The video is there. You cannot even detect. A security personnel went with a detective device to detect whether there is a bomb or something like that. And after he has used his own medicine, nothing was showing. And after opening it, immediately it explodes. And there and then it pieces the whole of him. Maybe after some time, some people will now use it to look at the video. I will leave this something here. Therefore, business environment is disrupted and the activities discontinued for the safety of people, life, and properties. All people fled in the first place, trying to look for safety of their lives. The methodology is a focus group discussion used in the internally displaced person camp in Yola, Adamawa State Capital, whereby it is the center of the IDP camps, where harbor about more than 4,500 internally displaced persons. So this was how we were before. This was how we were before. Businesses running. This is a daily basis activity. You can see people. You can see. This specifically, I put this one. This is mode of transportation in Nigeria, which is not here in Sri Lanka. This was how business was prior to the attacks. This is all. But after, look at what happens. Look at the market, stranded, properties destroyed. This is the after. Upon all the atrocities that committed by the Boko Haram, their downfall has come. Also, there is a video here that is showing the Boko Haram now has been defeated by the Nigerian army because they are now trying to come to truth, to come to table, such that they will now release their fellows who are remanded in the prison custody in exchange of the 200 girls they have kidnapped. So a video is here to show when they were appealing to the government that they would now exchange those 200 girls with those of their commanders who are remanded in government custody. So finally, the small and medium scale enterprises were being affected by the issue of this insurgency, destroying their businesses, everything. And at the end of the day, outsourcing is also being affected, but not to that extent, because most of the businesses that is being affected is small businesses, and outsourcing is based in medium and low,